The quickest way to get started with ClickHouse is to go to the quick start in the documentation and copy and paste that clever curl command, which downloads a single binary that can be used to run all sorts of tools with ClickHouse. I'm going to use it to run the ClickHouse server. First time you run it, it's going to create some files and folders in the current directory, like the config files and the data store folders and all those other useful things it needs. Once we have it up and running, in a different tab, I'm going to go back to this folder and run the same binary to run ClickHouse client. And when you see the little smiley face prompt, that means you're connected to ClickHouse. The first thing I want to do is show you how cool it is that ClickHouse can just read files from where they sit. So I have a zipped up, tab separated file sitting on S3 that has some New York City taxi data in it. You see that when I run the command to describe that file, ClickHouse infers the data types of the columns. If I want, I can query the data as it sits in S3. I don't have to bring it into ClickHouse yet. So here I'm running a simple query to figure out the average price per passenger count of these New York City taxi rides. And you can see here it processed 1 million rows in 24 seconds, but most of that time was streaming the data into ClickHouse. So let's create a table in ClickHouse to store that data. Now you can see here I'm using some ClickHouse data types like uint32 and float32 and low cardinality strings. And notice the table engine is merge tree. Every table in ClickHouse has to have an engine. When it's time to store the data in ClickHouse, you're going to want to store it into a merge tree table engine. And now I'm going to run this insert command. This is going to stream the data from S3 into my table. Notice there's something clever here. I did the curly braces with the 0.2. That's three files. It's trips_0, trips_1, and trips_2. And I could have used an asterisk for a wildcard also. Now that that's done, let's see how many rows we inserted. I'll do a quick select count from trips, and it's just over 3 million rows. So here I'll run the same query that we ran before, except this time it'll run on the data that's in the merge tree table in ClickHouse. And notice instead of taking 24 seconds, it took 0.024 seconds, so 24 milliseconds. Obviously, that's considerably faster. For more details on the examples and the queries that I just executed, look for the New York taxi data under the example datasets section of the documentation. And now that you have ClickHouse up and running, you're ready to put in your own data and get started.